What is the difference between classical and operant conditioning, and what are the four types of operant conditioning? In this video, I'm going to answer those questions with the help of my cats Thor and Loki, hopefully. I'm Maria, and in this channel, I'm here to help you understand child development concepts and to help you apply them. So a little while ago, I made a video about classical conditioning with my cats when they were kittens. They are 3 years old now and not as crazy active as they were, but they're still fun. But you'll see them in a little bit. But first, let me review what classical conditioning is. Classical conditioning is a behavioral procedure in which the condition stimulus, which is going to be the sound of the clicker, is paired with and precedes the unconditioned stimulus, which is seeing the cat treat, which elicits the unconditioned response, which is expecting food. Then eventually, until the conditioned stimulus, which is the clicker, alone is sufficient to elicit the conditioned response where the cat expects food just from the sound of the clicker. So here are the different parts. You have the cat treat, so you can see them right there. They are the unconditioned stimulus. And then you're going to have wanting the food, which is the unconditioned response because you don't have to train the cat to want the food when they see it. And then you have the clicker, which is the neutral stimulus, but once they pair the clicker to food, then it becomes the conditioned stimulus. And then coming at the sound of the clicker is the conditioned response. So let's see what happens when we click the clicker. All right, this is Thor. All right, Thor, good boy. Okay, not sure if Loki's gonna come. He's the naughty one, but he will, let me click that again. Okay, here's Loki, come on. All right, there you go. So now I'm gonna talk about operant conditioning, which explains how consequences lead to changes in voluntary behavior. You have reinforcement and punishment. Reinforcement increases the frequency of the desired behavior, and punishment decreases the frequency of undesired behavior. Positive is adding a stimulus, and negative is removal of a stimulus. You have both positive and negative reinforcement because they both seek to increase behavior. Positive reinforcement is a behavior that precedes the reward. So receiving a treat for shaking paws. So let's see if he'll do this. Loki, can you shake? Good boy. Can you shake other hand? Good boy. Here you go. Thor, you want to participate? Okay, well, and here's another one. Loki, up. Loki, up. Good boy. So that is positive reinforcement. It's a behavior that precedes a reward, and they know that if they do it, then after they perform the behavior, they will receive their reward. Okay, Loki, I'll let you do it again. Shake. Good boy. Shake other hand. Good boy. There you go. Thor, you want to try again? Shake. Shake. Good boy. Shake other hand. Shake other hand. Good boy. Okay, and Loki, I'm just gonna give this to you for being good. All right, there you go. Then you have negative reinforcement. This is behavior that leads to the removal of something negative. And the best example I could think of is how the cats have honestly trained me. You see, early in the morning, the cats annoy me by laying on my pillow, crawling on me, and just being annoying to try to wake me up. And so I get up to feed them so that they will stop being so annoying. So I'm the one who's getting up. So I'm being negatively reinforced, where my behavior of getting up will lead to removal of them being annoying. And both positive and negative punishment seeks to decrease behavior. Positive punishment is the addition of something undesirable as a consequence of negative behavior. So one thing that Loki does is that he loves my houseplants, and he will go and try to chew on them. So part of positive punishment is the addition of something undesirable as a consequence of negative behavior. So what I do is that when he tries to eat my plants, I usually have something loud, like my keys or something nearby, and then I shake it and it makes a loud noise, and then it scares him, and then he stops chewing on my plant. And because that's the addition of something undesirable, the sound of the loud noises, as a consequence of the negative behavior, chewing on my house plants. Then you have negative punishment, which is the removal of something desirable as a consequence of negative behavior. So again, sometimes when he chews on my plant, I remove the plant. He wants the plant, and then it's something that he desires. I remove it as a consequence of his negative behavior, which is again, chewing on my house plants. Don't you know that those plants may not be good for you? Good thing they're all non-poisonous. So I hope that this video and Thor and Loki have been able to help you learn the difference between classical and operant conditioning, as well as the four types of operant conditioning. Hit the like button, subscribe for future content, and then watch this video here. Thanks for watching, and see you in the next video.